Yo, you wanna hear the craziest shit?
What?
So you know all these crazy ass beats I've been making?
Yeah.
You know Egon?
Yeah, I know Egon.
So Egon sent me 100 vinyl from Now Again Records. Everything that he owns. I don't gotta worry about sample clearance, nothing. And that's what I've been on. So I was like, all right. I told Six, Kyle, Bobby Campbell, like just a core few homies, and Egon is coming out here. And for the next fucking 10 days, I'm going to make an entire album. And it's going to be dope.
Look at this shit. The black and brown American rock sound. Fire. Function Underground. Dude, I cannot believe he did this. Shout out to Egon, bro. This is incredible. Like, it's just because it's such quality. Like, this motherfucker sent me quality shit.
So why'd he do this?
He did this because... Do I really say?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Dark. That's what we gonna do. When I say go, we gonna go.
Yeah.
Go.
Ready to kick it, give a fuck about a bitch. Was with him for a decade, now we off without a hitch. I don't give a fuck if your shit went platinum. You can't fathom how in the fuck I'ma combat him. We independent, pick up the mic and I'ma vent it. If I said it, I meant it, came from the bottom and ascended. Now I think I'm a good father figure, cause I was sonning rappers before I was a father, go figure. My cryptocurrency is in the seven figures. If you talking shit, I roll up on you with like 11. My niggas ready to come and get us, fuck with us, it's me and all my hitters. Made a couple pop songs, made 100 million gross. Made a light for myself, for every night I need a toast. I was doing the most, said fuck rap, watch me ghost. I've been raising my son, blazing for fun, basking in the rays of the sun on my face. Took a step back, damn, I think I finally found my happy place. They say it's not a sprint, I say it's not a race. Coming up and
rapping. Hey, buddy. Bro, I don't think you under fucking stand how amazing this is, dog. Every record is incredible. Like, every record, like, yeah, bro. Every rec, like literally every single record I'm looking at. So like, okay, there's two things, right? Tone. I love funk because like with hip hop, I mean, that's what it's all about. Like finding these crazy ass loops. But like you have so much incredible black rock music. Like,
oh, dude.
But it's the wave I've been on. Like 10cc, yes. Like all that shit is what I'd be finding in record stores. But you got motherfuckers way better than that in the cut. This is crazy.
Dude, this makes me really happy, man. You know what? It's weird because when we first started talking about all this stuff, it wasn't like I was rushing to send it to you, because I figured there's going to come a point where he's going to just want to hear some stuff and then we can share it. And here we are.
Bro.
Isn't that wild?
Literally everything you sent me alone is a lifetime of shit worth to sample. Like, literally.
Oh, dude. Well, you know what? This is just the beginning, man. Me and you get to do this for the rest of our lives.
So wait, how many records does Now Again like have? Like,
hundreds. I put out hundreds. I've been doing this since 2002, putting out records. You know, reissues. Even when I was doing all the Dilla and Madlib stuff, I was always putting out reissues.
Dude.
Always.
Well, anyway, look, just know, dude, I am so, I fucking love you, bro. I'm so happy. I'm going through all this shit right now. I'm organizing it. I'm like, wait till you get here. We're gonna have an absolute blast. All right, brother, man. I'll talk to you soon, and I'm more than excited to see you, man. Thank you.
Me too. Thank you, Bobby.
All right, peace. What a good dude.
Goat.
Do I look old?
No.
Yes, dude.
As you can see, I am proficient in the art of digging. Your digging is no match for my
We kids. Are making an album in 2 weeks and handing it in, and then they'll be done.
Yeah, we've got to get it done in 2 weeks.
It's on the fly. We're like, fuck.
Yeah, I'm hyped to get back and just work, too. Even if it's under... these circumstances, it's still going to be fun.
Do you guys have a certain, like, mentality going into this project? What are you trying to make, or how you want to make it?
Finding ways to contribute to and elevate the vibe of whatever's inspiring us right now. For me, it's like, you know, utilizing more analog equipment just because we're gonna be sampling off vinyl. You're just gonna have that raw, gritty feel. So you want everything to be cohesive, and I think that's really the biggest thing, is just helping and not hindering, you know?
Hey, what's up, G? I'm about to do a crazy skit. Oh, you just missed the break alert.
Break alert.
So let's do...
As you can see, I am proficient in the art of sampling vinyl. I am proficient in the art of...
Sampling vinyl or vinyl sampling?
Or crate digging. Yeah. I was literally about to say that.
Or digging. Yeah. It's no match for my something style.
Yeah.
For my production style?
My kick style or something.
For my kick style. Yeah. Ooh, kick style. Kick style. That's hard. That's a dope title.
Yeah. Digging is no match for my kickstyle. What? Come at me with everything you have.
That's me?
Yeah. As you can see, I am proficient in the art of digging.
Your digging is no match for my kickstyle. Come at me with everything you have.
Prepare yourself. On guard.
You sound so cool.
Yeah, I didn't think I could sound like that.
As you can see, I am proficient in the art of digging. Yeah. Your digging is no match for my kick style. I'm God. Come at me with everything you have. Prepare yourself.
That's hard. Some shit. Yeah.
So.
Coming. Oh, geez, coming for the gig, bro.
I can't do this, man. That's all I have.
It's a workout, bro. God over here.
Yo, I got the monitor cracking. New haircut. What a new memory.
Take this off. Okay, now this one, take this off to you.
The last couple ones are good.
That's that Otis type figure.
What's up?
Word?
Yeah,
what's up, man?
No, it's
Jack. My G!
Woo!
Fuck yeah.
Yo, why are you fucking with me, man?
What?
I don't understand. Like, you're so cool. But yeah, you can be fucking with anybody.
Because I fuck with good people. And you're, you know, I don't waste time with people that have something going on and aren't good. Like, there's too many weird people in this world. You're a genuine dude from the first time I talk with you. That's just the way it is.
But that's how I feel about you. And I just have a genuine love for fucking music, man. Absolutely. And I just want to make good music. And I think the cool thing is like, I think a good reason of why we mesh, right, is because personally, like, we just fuck with each other.
Absolutely.
I think, like, sense of humor, music, I'm constantly learning from you, which I love. And on top of that, I feel like it's good business, too. You know what I mean? Like, it's like...
Absolutely. Are we sure the 58 is the way to go? I mean, we want it gritty, right? That's the point.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Yeah,
it's happening.
It's good enough for Jay-Z's.
Oh, yeah, it's good enough for Jay.
Yo, isn't this crazy? This is a vibe. Do you feel this?
Yes.
This is
absolutely
wild. Okay. And we have, like, 2 weeks left. I'm so excited.
Let's go.
Okay. Fucking everything. I remember two dope boys in Fake Shore Drive. I remember performing before this virus was alive. I remember commenting on Rap Genius threads. I remember arguing on Reddit hip hop heads before I was famous and criticized. I was just a member of the community. All right, right there. So, well, punch me. Before I was famous and criticized, I was just a member. Yeah. Before, on the one. Ready hip hop heads, yeah.
Final day street, bitch.
Hello.
Kyle on the guitar.
Hello.
Yeah. Final Days 3. It's just tight. When,
at the end, Ready Hip Hop heads.
Hey, Kyle. I'm gonna send you something. I'm gonna send you a clip tonight.
What is this? Is that the insert?
Yeah, it's just like the books that I wrote about the whole thing. Crazy, right?
You feel crazy.
Oh, I'm not sure this is bothering you. Right? I'm not sure. 10 years ago.
Damn, look at sexy Egon. I know.
God, young Egon.
Ready?
Yes.
Alright,
show me.
Alright, so I flip this acapella.
Retire, I snatch you up with the needle nose pliers. Let me drill a Omaha whore with the elbow you never seen before. Glide in the glaze, like long peak, you know what you mean. Like a bracelet with the bass, so not goofy like Darren, I hate so.
And in there, I heard two syllables that when put together say bleed it. And like I'm bleeding on the track, so when I write my raps, it's like I'm fucking bleeding it.
Bleed that, that's when I bleed that. Think I'm too lead that. Who be like bleed that? With lead that. When my mom watching Ten Commandments, got a bottle in her hand and I'm facing abandonment. Social services fucking up my vibe. Smiling for the worker, but I'm dying on the inside. Ha 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 ha, everything's fine. Sometimes I feel like I'm losing my mind. I seen a lot of shit in my lifetime. Playing the field, man, I need another lifeline. 50-50, I was born to be a fuck up. What up? Always been myself, so shut the fuck up! Alright, and then we'll go. Punch me. A criminal I was in my past life. Nothing but women and drugs, it was a fast life. I got 911 on FaceTime. Walking in the bank, Glock 9 in my waistline. Empty the clip, nah, I never waste. Fuck, punch me. Woo! Punch me right there. Play it, wait. Yeah, just before. Just play it. Alright, right there, in my waistline, and I come in after. I got 911 on FaceTime, walking in the bank, block 9 in my waistline. Empty the clip, fuck no, I never waste time. Grab the cash, the gas to the baseline. I'm bleeding, I'm fucking bleeding. Been in love, been heartbroken, been ice cold, been shaken up, but I never fold.
Alright, fuck that last part, that shit's whack. Yeah, let's play it from the end.
That's just Tuesday. Anybody hot?
What was it like being in the studio with Dylan when he was doing what we're doing here? What was the vibe? What was it like?
Well, I mean, like, you know, when I was with him, it was mainly in the hospital. You know, like, prior to that, if I was in the studio with him, it was like in a different phase of the creation of the record. So in the hospital, it was largely like this, except it was mainly editing. But, like, I gotta say that, like, you know, being around him or Doom or Otis, even when they were, like, actually creating, it was like these moments were few and far between, you know? Like, those dudes created privately. You know, Dylan created sometimes with other people, like the Soul Aquarian, Badu, and
yeah, yeah.
Them, but like, you know, like places, him and Madeline never got together and made a beat or something, or hung out like we're hanging out like now.
That's wild. This is fucking insane.
Are you about to chop some shit up?
Oh, am I?
Woohoo! Listen to that. Dude, so this is an example of a record that has been nothing but a money loser for me. This dude just hit me up 3 weeks ago.
Money loser?
Total money
loser.
Oh,
he's thinking about to make some money.
Listen, this dude just hit me up like 3 weeks ago asking me what's going on. I'm like, bro, I can't control this shit, but I'm telling you, I believe in your music. No one's cared
up until this point. But you know what? I believe that sometime, someplace, somebody's going to care. Look where we are. Isn't that weird?
That's fucking crazy.
You care.
Like, he literally just hit me up.
Dude. That's fire.
That's fucking crazy, man.
He's going to be gas.
How beautiful is this music, man?
He's going to be gas.
It's so beautiful.
He quit, but I don't know where I'm going with this.
If you do that, it's going to fit perfect, bro.
Okay, all right. We'll put it right on. This is the ninth record of his that I've actually really gone to. I've gone to a couple more, honestly. But, like, I've already picked, so I've got, like, 16 beats. That's fucking crazy.
Keep going.
Shit's Hadouken fighting.
So this year, we did it for 10 years. Same process. It's digging.
Constant search
for the
perfect
loop. And
then you make something, and then you're like,
eh. Yep, trying to dig again.
All right.
You make a beat, and then you dig again. It's an endless cycle, honestly.
That's life, though.
That's life.
I'm like, it's like almost I do a letter to Quaz or Madlib, and I'm like, yep. But I do it in the Quaz voice, so I'll rap like I'm Quaz, and I'm like, hey, yo, Quaz, it's your cousin, my nigga. Like, so it's like it's me.
Right.
Well, it's like a cousin. We'll give him a name.
Yeah.
And then I'll be like, you ain't rapping so long. Like, I heard you and Logic doing the whole album, not just a song. And da da da. How the fuck you ain't gonna rap? Like, you, I don't know. Like, you love you, we miss you.
I don't even know if that's the right song. I mean, it's hard, but I don't even know if that's the one I was talking about. Yeah. Okay, yeah, it's the photo.
Or maybe not.
Wait, pause that real quick. I can't hear your voice.
Yeah,
okay,
absolutely.
How long is the song?
It's
the same song. Mad Lib, my man, come to fuck back, damn. Show the people that you understand what I'm saying. Mad Lib, my man. Mad Lib, my man, come to fuck back, damn. Again? That's that Kanye. Let me stand up. Mad Lib, my man, come to fuck back, damn. Show the people that you understand what I'm saying. Quasimodo flow toe-to-toe with any spitter. Hip-hop needs you in this company, the Black John Ritter. In the lab, again? Mad lip, my man, come the fuck back, damn. Show the people that you understand what I'm...
Again?
Mad lip, my man, come the fuck back, damn. Show the people that you understand what I'm saying. Quasimodo flow toe-to-toe with any spitter. Hip-hop needs you in his company, the black John Ritter. In the lab, you said people don't want to hear my shit. I should smack you, brother, they revere that shit. Come back, run it back, neutralize them like Men in Black. From Stone's Throw to Mad Lip Invasion. Ask any fan on the street or say your shit is amazing. The GOAT, a god. Right there, the GOAT, the GOAT. How's that sound, good?
Sounds great.
All right, let's go.
What a letter. Yo, punch up the vocals. Do some cuts right there without listening. I'm going to call Six up. Hey, Six. Six. Let's go. Come here. I want you to listen to this. I want you to think about what Madlib and Dilla mean to you. Mm-hmm. Not just as who you've become, but just as a fan back when you were fucking.
Saying what you instilled in me. Hip hop from J-Lib to Mad Villainy. You are the sound of our ancestors. Come back and rap, man. It's killing me.
That's a bar.
I mean,
the whole show is a bar, but yeah.
You hear what I said,
man? Yeah. Wait,
we're
running
back. Yeah, sorry. Nigga, you a little free. I was on.
I had to write you now, or else I probably never would. I don't want you full of regret, like, damn, man, I should. I don't think you understand.
Because I was playing a record, and he was like, this era of logic. So now I was like, yo, she was dope. I'm old. I got wrinkles. Check these out. For years and years, I felt like a fraud. I felt like a fraud because all I have to do is take somebody else's shit and then take a break loop and then create a hat. I felt like a fraud and like an imposter because I was taking other shit to like make some ill shit.
That's normal.
But that's what music is. Take away hip hop, bro. Motherfuckers with certain bass lines, or you could take three notes of a Madonna song that inspires fucking 34 bars of a completely different melody, man. And we all out here trying to act like, nah, this shit's original, this is my shit, this. The reason I use the Mantronics Dilla Siren is because I want to keep Dilla alive. I sampled Dilla, but Dilla sampled Mantronics, and Mantronics sampled some fucking World War II horn.
Right, exactly.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
Boy, is it
one of them?
Give you a 16 and then you can arrange it.
No, I can't arrange shit, nigga. I'm on tape.
Oh, fuck.
I can't arrange shit. I'm on tape. So do this. We are recording a track directly through the Tascam Porta 1 that Mac DeMarco recommended that he did Salad Days on, the whole Salad Day, or Salad Days demos, I should say. Thank you, G. I was at his house working on a record we're doing. Hopefully we'll get done. I've just been on some other shit. I've been on some rap shit, honestly. It's a sound unlike any other sound. So I think I'm gonna... Oh yeah, that sounds really good. I think I'm gonna do this on this motherfucker and do my thing.
I think you should go aggressive too.
And I'm excited. Oh yeah.
Like the way Riz is saying, bring the mother... Like, you know what I mean? Yeah, hit your verse like that. Come on, man. Go crazy.
It's crazy. Yo! I come rough, tough like an elephant tusk. I'm that motherfucker Tarantino, dawn till dusk. Hit the homie Mac DeMarco like, what up, my man? I need some raw shit, and he recommended the Tascam. I'm talking hip-hop shit straight to tape. He did the Salad Days, then the show, the hip-hop, and I'm a trap. Open up your chest like, oh, yes, like, do the best, oh, yo, fuck.
Now we off without a hitch. I don't give a fuck if your shit went platinum. You can't fathom how in the fuck I'ma combat them. We independent. Pick up the mic and I'ma vent it. If I said it, I meant it. Came to the bottom in the Senate.
Yeah, shit's about to be dope. Again, take me to just before the drop, like the real, when the shit kicks in.
Sun on my face, took a step back. Damn, I think I finally found my happy place. They say it's not a sprint.
Oh my fucking god, again.
Sun on my face, took a step back. Damn, I think I finally found my happy place. They say it's not a sprint, I say it's not a race. Coming up in it's not a race. Coming up in rap 10 years ago, I felt so out of place again. They say it's not a sprint,
Again?
Sun on my face, took a step back. Damn, I think I finally found my happy place. They say it's not a sprint,
God damn it, dude. Fuck, again.
Sun on my face, took a step back. Damn, I think I finally found my happy place. They say it's not a sprint, I say it's not a race. Coming up in rap 10 years ago, I felt so out of place. Shit was different, if you had beef, you did it face to face. Check the...
Alright, great.
A sponge.
That's kind of where I hear it.
Where is it?
That's a little bit
after this. Oh.
Somebody's been asking to see you. Is that okay?
Yeah. Come on in. I just am doing this, but we can do it together.
Yes.
Yeah.
How you been, Kyle?
Oh, yeah, that's the piano.
Good,
listen to the beat.
It's just a spy bar.
We have been recording and producing Vinyl Days, the album. And it's like some of the most fun I've ever had making an album. So for the last 3 days, no wonder I feel out of it. I've been going ham, bro.
No, what? JT? You don't want JT to film you?
So good.
No, okay.
Hey, you don't yell at your mother. Can you say sorry?
No. Good boy. It's okay.
Now you show me how you take a bite right now. Show daddy.
No.
Show
You're
daddy.
You're gonna love it. Okay,
we'll
wait a minute.
Oh, okay, so then you don't want any dinosaurs, I guess.
No, it's okay. He doesn't have... We can't...
You want more? Then take a bite.
No, it's okay. I don't want to force him to eat.
Good boy. Now you keep eating for your mom, okay? Can you say, my name is Bobby?
Me, Bobby.
Good job. Say, hello.
Hello.
Say, hi.
Hi.
Say, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Say... Say, sup, dude?
Say Bobby.
Bobby.
Bryson.
Hall.
He said Hall. But say Bryson. Hall.
Whoa.
Go the fly.
You know what's funny is I feel like I look hella slick until I do this card heart patch.
I'm like EPing this motherfucker. But me and Six, it's just we're always a group no matter what. But I think the big difference here is like Six would really define the direction of where and how things would go because he was making the beats. So he would just make the beats and I would just kind of wait. Like, all right, what you got? Like, and I'm listening. But he would do everything. With this, I'm basically starting every idea or overseeing everything and producing like a motherfucker on it, which is pretty cool. So.
Is that more tiring than usual?
I am fucking exhausted. Yeah, it's actually really crazy because, bro, sampling is one thing, like sitting on your computer, lazy on the couch, going through Spotify, but it's so unfulfilling. I've always hated doing that because it's like, there's something different about vinyl. If you're gonna take the plastic off a record, and then open the slit, and then bring out the vinyl and flip it on its side and take the vinyl out, set it on a player, grab the needle. It might seem all like, oh, whatever. Okay, but do that 100 times in a day. And it, so it's a process, bro. But it's also, you know, it's... You get this shit that you hear in the background. It's an art, man, and it's a beautiful thing, and I love it, and I'm so happy that this is what I do for a living.
I'm like, oh shit, I can lay that down. Just send me the audio, and that's what I did.
Let me ask you a question though. For this joint, so you haven't listened to it yet, right?
No, because I got a deadline. I'm doing a secret album that's about to that I can't even discuss, but.
It's my last album on Def Jam, and we sampling everything straight from vinyl, and like it's the craziest shit.
Why don't you send me some of the stuff you have, and then I'll look at some of the acapellas I have. Ooh, and then can it be done in the next like 2 days?
That would be perfect, actually. That'd be perfect timing.
3 days tops, but I'll be done with the project that I'm doing.
Okay, man, you're the shit.
Yeah, and I'll definitely knock it out for you.
I appreciate that, man. Thank you so much.
Not a problem.
Have fun, man. Enjoy today in the studio.
Okay. Appreciate you, bro.
All right, G. Peace. Date night today. I'm taking Miss Britt, Miss Hall. Taking Miss Hall out. And I'm gonna...
How are you doing? I lost my fucking
getting meat. Seasoning my pizza. This is what you get after you work in the studio.
Well, here's
good. 5 days straight.
Yeah, he's a ranch.
GG. Put the camera down. Mm-hmm. Take a slice of pizza.
It's on the technique of the throw. Mm-hmm. See, this is... Can we show...
But do you fold?
Can we show the difference? This is true ranch artisanship.
Disbursement.
And this...
Oh! Nardwar sent me the message. Oh, I thought he wasn't going to do it. Did I play you the beat? Oh, you don't even know. I gotta play you. Come here. And I was like, this is like Nardwar's theme. So I literally hit Nardwar and I was like, hey bro, can you... please send me like a voicemail or some shit and I'll put it on my album. And he didn't respond to me. And I was like, damn.
So he just sent it to me. So let's listen to it. This is about to be in.
Oh, he's digging sent me a movie.
What?
Oh, this is crazy.
Hi, Logic.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Yo, I fucking love this guy.
Hi, Logic. It's Nardwar, that human serviette from Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada, saying, please keep on sampling in the free world. And
that's amazing.
Wow.
Oh, this motherfucker really fucked. Yo, that is the most gangster shit of all fucking time, dog.
Keep on sampling in the free world.
Keep on sampling in the free world, bro.
That's hard as fuck.
Yeah, I don't think you understand how hype I am right now. That's oh my god, we doing this beat right now. Yeah, you're the intro for the song, and I use your vocals as the main part of the beat. So, like, I chopped you up on my MPC saying, so you go, it's Nardwar from British Columbia, or Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada, and I took the British part, and I just British, and I put drums over it, and that's the whole beat.
Can I get a sub? Can we get, like, a, what do you think? Or should we do live bass?
Oh, we got the bass downstairs.
You're probably gonna want to follow this key though.
Yeah, I figured it out.
You already know what it is.
Yeah, I loved the song even before the thing you sent me on,
the voice message. I love that. I couldn't believe it. Like, it was so cool. That's why I appreciate it, because it's just incredible that you would turn something I did into magic like that with a cool 60s sample. It wasn't something whack. It was amazing. It was something I would sample. And I was honored by that because, you know, a lot of times I give people ideas and they don't follow through with them, and it makes you kind of depressed. But to have somebody actually do something, you know, to follow through with what you said is amazing. But nobody ever followed through. So for you to follow through in something is incredible.
Well, thank you, Narwar. I love you. And everything you say is gold. So how can I not take your advice or be inspired by you, bro?
Dude,
peace out.
Bye.
Yeah, I'm about to call Doc. Doc D was not so good on this fucking beat, bro.
Yo, what's up?
Yeah.
Yeah, what?
What?
I'm dealing with this sharing shit, man. You know, my bitch is crazy, man. I'm trying to get
her. Bro, back. She doesn't want to be with you, bro. It's fuck Sharon because that's what you said. Anyway, listen to me, bro. I just fucking flipped Narwar. Like, literally, I had Narwar send me
what?
A message. I asked him to call my phone and leave me a message. This motherfucker filmed a video message. I can't believe it.
Oh.
Like, shout me out. And it and I, like, sampled Narwar.
Oh.
Yeah, Narwar. And I sampled him, and it sounded amazing. And I think you would kill the raps. Are you down?
Okay, that's dope. That's dope.
No, man. Are you down or not? I don't give a fuck. Come on.
Yeah, don't. Fuck it.
All right, bet. All right, love you, man. All right, peace.
Trying the body, tourniquet. Several shots, they try and body like a tourniquet. They tying up your body with a tourniquet. Let them rock. It's obvious that turn it is. I'm learning this. See your favorite artist do the most just for grins. I seen a grown man lying just to get the pennies. I'm cooking like grannies. The recipe is sick and we got extras in the pantry. Is that dope how I'm kind of out of breath right there? I'm not the socialite type, but my vocal's quite right. I'm still spitting raps like it's open mic night. I'm still getting played from the hoes you might like. I'm still getting paid off the flows you probably like.
How long is that, man?
4 minutes.
Wow. Of just bars. Let's hear it, man. This shit is dope, bro.
It goes like he rolls with the left hand. With light text and told, I suppose it's a lesson. Question, how you woke, but you slept in. Treading on your rappers like Midas for over 10 years without changing tires. Shit, I should probably check the bias. Back on my hustle, got packs in the dough. Push rhymes like weight. Yeah, you know I'm taxing the dough. I'm in the pocket like a running back. Running back.
Oh, my God! Burn the shit out of my finger. Let's see what time it is. It's 2:45. That's a get back to that watch, baby. That's an early night, am I right? You can say yes.
Yes.
Did that shit look dope?
Probably, I hope so.
What do you mean probably?
I mean,
we've done a lot of work, man. I think we should chill tomorrow. I think we should chill. I think we should all chill together, man. We should fuck around, watch movies, hang out, smoke.
You got a grill? I think so. No music. Yo, I know us. I'm fucking serious. All right, one fucking day off so that we can all fucking chill. No music. All right? Yep. Nobody even up music. How about this? How about this? For real. We don't listen to the music. We don't talk about the music. Don't talk about shit. We don't talk about shit. Even if I have an idea, no music, no nothing tomorrow. And then we come back Sunday, and it's just going to be like, oh, we listen to the whole thing. Oh, it's going to be great. Okay, cool.
Love you guys, bro.
Day 5, 14 songs, all from the heart. BC Mix, Bobby Campbell. Just showed up to mix the fucking album. Kyle's been snapping engineering. He's up there right now.
So this is his setup here to mix vinyl bass.
He put his speaker stands on unreleased Bobby Boy suitcases. Kind of fire. Fans be like, oh, when he takes his time, that's the best. Like, you get the best shit when you take your time. But they don't know the fucking Young Sinatra mixtapes were made in like 3-4 weeks.
I got the bounce, more bounce to the ounce. And you already know, yeah, I come around. Big Pep in the place. Justin and JT, in the way.
Yo, I don't even know what the fuck you saying. I don't even know why you trying to be playing. I just came to get it this year. That's why I got some chopsticks in my ear.
Bobby Flay, cooking up beats. Postman on the streets.
Preach.
Got his ear to the streets.
Yeah.
It's crazy how some people can hate us and think they know what to say, but they don't know what to say. Nuts. This right here, though, this.
Yeah, yeah.
There we go. That's what the fuck I'm talking about.
Yeah. Still in the game with you. Wetting fools like when the rain hits you. Music, movies, and families. I'm a lane switcher. Ready to get you now. My flow make you rethink your whole fucking style. Nick Cannon on these motherfuckers. Bobby going wild. As a youngin', as a child, I was dreaming for this. Fiending for this. Listen, lean in with this. I'm the definition of a try-hard.
Black white boy is the illest name. Like, think about that name. That title, Black White Boy. Like, what the fuck? Am I right? That's hard. Black White Boy? And it's just people are gonna be like, oh, here he is again. And they're gonna play it. They're gonna talk about it. They're gonna listen to it. Like, it's smart. You know what I mean? Call it Black White Boy. People are gonna be like, what the fuck?
In the whole clan for show. I do this for most. Do this for thought. Do this for Dilla on the Farilla. But don't let me start showing love, cause I won't be able to stop. Made 50 million when I went pop. But everybody know when Logic pick up the mic, bars drop. I respect this generation, but I need the hardest bars you can provide. I'm taxing you with inflation. Bobby Boy in a cut like a Mason. I got verses like Freddie Jason. Fucking amazing.
You have to do it again. Yeah,
Thursday night, Bob calls me and my pops, and he's like, yo, I'm going to play the project and shit. So we're listening to it. We're listening to it. It's fucking amazing. And then we get to a certain track. He's like, this is what I want you on. I was like, oh, shit. You know, he's essentially played a huge, huge role in me learning how to do it for myself and contribute back, you know, what I've learned is... It's a beautiful thing that kind of just comes full circle.
I'm out of pocket more. My birthing doctors was about as healing as Aquaphor. That still ain't stopping me. My tongue is sharp as a Tory handle swords. I swing at these beasts. Till I'm eating sashimi. Eat to Dakimasu. Really, I do humbly receive. This meal indeed. In 10, 11 sentences can be with my cutlery. Rap pack shit, motherfucker. Y'all know what's up. It's vinyl days. All right,
let's make me look better somehow. I got Teflon,
vagabond. Microphone madness, one step beyond. Turn around and look at decade we've been on. Rap pack, nigga, now we never switch form. And I'm right back, nigga, like I never been gone. Fuck home, ring the alarm like tennis on. When I grab the mic, you know I drop bombs. Jump off stage, get fake like bombs.
Make it stay now, we gon' make it. Only changing that I did would be changing the game. Only time I switch lanes in that new same. I never...
Fuck! Fuck, man. I didn't do shit. I didn't change shit. I didn't touch shit. And it fucking switched my whole shit. Now I gotta go all the way back and I'd rather have this than that. And it's just fucking whack.
When you up, then she gon' change.
Fucking whack, bro. Fucking garbage. That's not what I did. I didn't fucking do that bullshit. What the fuck is even happening? Ugh. Fucking hate. I hate this shit. I hate when fucking technology just, oh, you had the whole beat, everything was good. Guess what? Last second, I'ma just fuck your whole shit. Shit is whack. Fucking delete.
I'm always dropping.
I gotta do a whole new shit. I forgot what the fuck I already did. I loved it. I fucking loved it. Changing, it's not even fucking changing, bro. That shit is whack as fuck, bro. Come on, you fucking, come on, bro. I'm just like, Nick, what the fuck? I did all this work, man. I did all this shit, and it fucking goes back, man. I fucking slave away at this shit, and technology want to be like, oh, only audio effects can be inserted on audio track, you fucking bitch, bro. What the fuck are you talking about? What the fuck? Copy, bro. Fucking copy. And then I go over here and I fuck. Yo, if you don't let me paste this, fuck some shit up, dog. This is fucking bullshit. Fucking hate. Honestly, I'm gonna be real, bro. I might look like a little kid on a playground all pissed off. When you fucking put this much time, this much fucking effort, this many years, you know your program. You know the shit. You know what the fuck it's supposed to do, and it doesn't fucking do it. It's bullshit, bro. It's fucking bullshit. It's bullshit. Yo, Kyle, come here. If I'm a fucking moron, bro, it's all Gucci, bro. I just want to know why the fuck shit ain't working. I go here. I do fucking this shit. Copy it. Hit copy.
This intro got to be strong enough to make a few people scared.
It's got to be on a MIDI.
To back down. And if I'm giving that energy, niggas is gonna know he's gonna be the one who's gonna want it. He's gonna deal with me. He's gonna try to take it on. And I want them to think that. And the first nigga that fucking sends a fucking tweet.
Retire for what? It's the birth of the black white boy.
Bar for bar, what you want to do? The bar for bar, bro. That's how we got to ride out. That means we call niggas whack. This, that, that. Bar for bar. Or don't talk to us.
We just shot a music video. This is going to be a cool cutaway.
Oh.
I haven't traveled in 3 years. I haven't shot shit like this in a very long time. I haven't shot music videos like this since my mixtapes, bro. Like, just stealing every shot, fucking going ham with it.
Oh, the conference room. How do you turn these lights off?
Where I sat and played my album for the first time. For all the executives, a lot of motherfuckers was on their phone and shit while I was playing it. Or like leaving.
I hope I don't have to pee a lot. You know me, I'd be having a piss. We about to smack the jizz in chess. We about to play jizz in chess. This is like dream come true. Yeah, straight up.
Super hot.
Do I look like a little kid? Because I'm so excited right now.
A lot younger than I do. A lot younger than me.
You look good.
What's that?
It's sinus.
Oh yeah, no doubt.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah,
can you make it out to eBay?
Oh. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, I go to Writing Logic.
No, to Logic, yeah, I'm joking.
That's a cool one.
To eBay.
You be roaring like a lion when you get that mic in his hand.
That's how I feel, though, because I'm like a really chill dude.
Right.
I'm like... Cause I like to. I don't think I'm an arrogant person, but it's like on the microphone, I'm the best rapper in the world, right? That's how you got to be. So when you're on the stage, it's like you have to command the crowd.
I tell you one thing not to do, which most artists have a habit of doing, and depending on them, hype men.
I'm not saying that don't ever have one or have anybody back you up. That's cool because we all do it or done it. But some people get so dependent on that that they can't perform without a hype man. You ready? Set yes. it. Set it. It's going to be fast this time.
Are we going? Okay, let's go.
Yeah, it's going to be fast, Logic. You know, I ain't giving none of that up this time. Oh, you found the pocket. You found the pocket, Logic. Smart move. You found the pocket. I gotta throw some protection on that. Okay, Logic. I'm gonna figure this out one way or the other. Chess boxing with Jizza and Logic. It's been a great evening. Catch us next time. Stay tuned. Peace. Fun, yeah.
Yeah. Yo, me and Jizzle went back and forth. I came out the gate garbage. You saw that. I was like, damn it. I was nervous. And then the second game, I was coming through, bro. And then we just kept going like this. But to be fair, I think I got more L and more dubs because of the time.
Give me a really sus voice, and I want you to tell me where we are, what album we're wrapping up, and yeah, go.
Sus voice?
And who you are.
No, I'm Schwy. I'm the guy. We're here at Germano Studios.
Where?
New York City, Soho, and we're finishing up Vinyl Days right now. Neradu. And we're trying to pick songs right now. We got 24, we're trying to get to 12. I think you should drop the 24 and then drop 24 music NFTs after.
Okay, so this motherfucker Logic flies all the way to New York to play chess with Jizza for the show that he does. And let me tell you, this is the first time actually anybody beat Jizza in this chess series, in these chess games. So let's just say Logic served him up a Queen's Gambit.
Egon got the Latash in his cellar. My rhymes affect the game, Mandela. Vinyl days kinda like the days of Rockefeller. Yeah, I'm on the beat, but you know I murder acapella. I step in Def Jam building the other day. I ain't asked for 50 million like I was Jay. I shot the video for Tetris and all.
This is the part I hate. I hate the part when the anxiety sets in and I'm so tired right now and my body is just like, bro, get in the car and just go to the hotel. I just got anxiety. I just been thinking about it, man. I've been going nonstop, shooting videos, seeing people, dinners. Like, it seems like it's like, oh yeah, it's great, we're having dinners, dude. But it's like, my mind is racing. I'm going over edits, mixes, you know what I mean? Fucking writing raps, doing all this shit. And it's funny because I just came out here to play chess. And then it turned into this whole thing. And like, even right now, I just feel so tired. But like, I gotta knock this verse out. I don't gotta. I could do whatever I want, but it's the last night. It's the home run. You know what I mean? It's the ninth, bottom of the ninth with two outs. You know what I mean? Like, think about the month. Think about all the shit on my plate, the employees that I have, the people I pay, the families that eat because of me. Leaving the only place I've ever known as a home for 10 years to then go be independent and really do it on my own. It's a scary thing. It's a lot of things that I think are like building up and it's so much going on. And I just feel tired, man.
They say one door closes, a window opens or something like that. But this is all my doing, my dudes. Like, I'm leaving the label. I'm going to do what I want to do. And this is what I want to do. I want to make raw hip-hop shit, and then I want to go make a pop album or whatever. Like, you know what I mean? Or do, like, not pop, but, like, alt rock. Or I'm going to do whatever the fuck I want, man. But this shit is, like, I don't like this feeling.
I feel tired, but, like, I really want to do this verse, but I'm so tired. Andrew.
No, for the content. What's his name?
His name's Andy.
Andy's nuts.
I love you guys. Can we do this super quick while I got the energy? I mean, when I go home, I need to really rest.
Okay, play from the top, please.
Yeah.
It was fun.
Hey, yo.
Yeah. Fun and it hurts. All right, what the fuck you doing? You're singing. Ready?
Happy birthday to you.
I'm not trying to put you on the spot. You ain't gotta suck my dick. You can keep it 100%. Keep it fucking real. I know there's misconceptions of me. I'm a mainstream artist. I'm a this, I'm a that. Why do you think Logic, right? Because we're talking about this is how people are going to hear it. Why do you think Logic is important to hip hop? And if you had to express to somebody who's so stuck in their ways, like, why is Madlib fucking with Logic? Why is it this? Why is it that? How would you describe and explain to them why?
Okay.
Why?
I can do that.
Logic as a rapper is an anomaly, a person who's out of time, living in the present, you know, rooted in the past, but a traditionalist who believes in the future and who believes in what hip-hop was and can still be. So we're here in this modern time thinking about and listening to the development of hip-hop and its future all at once. I think that a lot of people in the modern sense of the word get caught up in how fleeting time is, and they believe that what's happening right in front of them is the most immediate thing and it's the most meaningful thing, and they have to engage what's happening in the moment because the moment's going to be gone and then they're not going to care, or no one else around them is going to care. And I think we forget that great experiences in humanity go on for decades, centuries, sometimes millennia, before anybody even really knows how to make sense of them. And so in the same way that the monks in the Dark Ages were keeping records and saving books, you know, it is important for us to really make sense of one of America's great folk musics, and that's hip-hop. And there's very few people who care enough to actually keep the form going while trying to push it forward. Logic's one of those dudes, and the reason Madlib and I decided that we wanted to work with him is because he came through with a true sincerity and appreciation for the form and for all of the people that make it, and like a true understanding of craft and like who's doing what and how their technique is either important, relevant, something that needs to be preserved or not. And I remind myself that even though hip-hop seems to me in my mid-40s to be an old thing because it's been around since the early 70s, it's actually just in its infancy. And if it's not for people like Logic trying to keep this tradition alive, we're not really gonna know, even shortly after, what's supposed to come. This hopefully is an art form that's gonna outlast all these art forms that preceded and informed it. And we're only gonna know that if people who truly have the passion, belief, and the proficiency, the musical acumen to hold the form, hold it dear, and at the same time not be so reverent to it and push it forward, are there to show us the way. So hopefully he's one of those dudes. I have that belief.
Drop the mic.
Yo, my guy, bro.
I mean, but I believe that, though.
Thanks, man.
I mean, I really do, and I believe in a lot of ways, you know, like, I'm not saying this, you know, this is just me and you talking now, but...
It is.
Like,
you can start recording. This is just us. You can start recording.
No, look, in a lot of...
Overnight, that was like
crazy. That was a crazy ass video.
Because then we did that in Japan, too.
So yeah, that's Shibuya, though. You know what I'm saying, though?
Okay, go in the booth.
What do you want me to say?
Let's just go crazy.
Right
now.
Yeah, just go crazy.
What's the lyric? Oh, it's over here.
Yeah.
Is it recording? Are you recording?
Yeah. Oh.
Was that it?
Yeah. No. Oh yeah.
No.
Why are you busting out your phone like you got notes?
Let me get the ad lib, though.
I don't know what I'm saying, though. What's going on? I can't hear you, but I can see you guys laughing.
I want to laugh with you.
Oh, yeah. JT? Yeah. Silly boy.
Yeah! Yeah! Actually, that was pretty dope there. I ain't gonna lie.
Bro, JT, we're at fucking Halal, guys. We just finished the album. We gotta treat ourselves to the best food in the city.
Extra white sauce.
It's going great.
We gotta treat ourselves to this shit, man.
Cut me out of all the documentary footage.